playing a very good offensive and back defensive first half.
Back to receive the ball, number 22, Keontae Brown.
Now we just spoke with Mr.
Number 32, Alex Minton.
One of the baseball coaches here at basketball, and he said that Menlo Park really needs
and number
to
25, Zach
just plug the middle, you know, really stop the
kicking
run.
Off.
Well, USC needs to expand.
100% clear.
The
number 15, Ben Stolnacker.
USC also needs to limit mistakes, interceptions, fumbles, you know, play fundamentally sound football. Well, Menlo Park needs to put up more points on the board and not rely on their offense as much. And here we go, start the second half. Keontae Breyer hit a 90-yard touchdown for his first time out. I guess that man will be a block in the back.
Keontae Breyer on the return of flags on the play.
Number 34, Brian Rock.
Illegal block in the back on Bethel Park.
That will be a block in the back, folks.
Always put at the 6-yard line of Bethel Park, first down and 10. Second down 6 for the Hawks.
Ball to their own 11, second and 6.
Double student section still well into it. And oh, and he is stopped. The Enoch is stopped. No gain on the play. So it will bring up the third down
to carry. Stopped by number 72, John Looper. No gain, third down 6 for the Hawks. First on the bench for Bethel Park.
And Jake Ryder down to
Ball down spotted in St. Clair territory. After a 49-yard punt.
That's decent position.
Ball spotted at the 41-yard line.
I'll give you an injury update. Austin Park, the star center for St. Clair, is still out of the game. They still have the backup center.
Ladies and gentlemen, get your 50-50 raffle tickets ready, and we'll be announcing the winner at the next stop and play. Winning amount tonight, $1,025. Get it ready.
First and 10 here on their own 41-yard line for these USC guys.
Ball goes out. They give us out number 32. Steve
McCullough. Randall going to carry. Tackle by number 68.
Evan Yarger,
no gain. Second down 10 for the Panthers.
Stop here with me and everything for Washington. but still a great stop by the Bethel
Park. Fahimi on the keeper.
That has to get the Bethel Park too. And that was only gain of 1 yard, all the top of two. That was one of the second 9 yard blocks. 505 run.
Gain of one, second down nine for the Hawks.
I know I mentioned this earlier, but USC, are you looking at the fans? Their student section has been crazy over. I haven't seen anything
since the first half.
And keeping their fans out of the game is big.
Trying to get set 5 seconds off of the play clock. Then he realizes that the light grip jumps across, and that'll move them back.
Half the distance
to the goal
line. Flags on the play, motion on Bethel Park. Half the distance to the goal. Second down nine to the Hawks.
And Nathaniel wants to pass, and he'll fire it down to Avery Dibble.
Oh! Passes it to number 10, Avery Dibble, incomplete.
Flashing back to last week.
Calling on the coverage. We have a third down nine for the Hawks.
Flashbacks last week when he had those two drop touchdowns. A beautiful ball by Nathaniel. He put it right on the money.
I'm not sure. I couldn't really tell from here, but I think the USC defender actually put a hand in there. So
Pete Coughlin able to break up that pass.
Coughlin proved to be a back
drop. I like the call by Nathaniel.
But it is a 31 at the 1 yard.
They will give it off to John Mascara, who rushes his way.
Mascara on the carry.
For a yard.
Back up by number 13, J.J. Kahn.
Oh, and they are hurrying up here. They don't want USC to get any chances of blocking this game.
Score now reads, Bethel Park 10, Upper St. Clair 9.
Matt
Carr. Ladies and gentlemen, get your 50-50 raffle tickets ready. We'll be announcing the winner. Winning
on
tonight, $1,025. It is a dark pink ticket. A dark pink ticket.
Well, I was hoping that wouldn't happen, Mike.
784-429. 784-429. With the winner, please report to the Homeside Concession Stand at this time. We'd like to thank everyone for playing.
That may have, I honestly feel that may have.
On behalf of the Bethel Park Boosters Board, we would like to thank and extend a huge thank you to all parents who volunteered their time to support our Bethel Park football team. Thank you, one and all. The Boosters would also like to thank Shop and Stadium and Kansas Shannon for the ongoing support of our football program. Danny Christensen to kick off for the Blackhawks. Flag on the play. Illegal procedure on Bethel Park, kicking the ball out of bounds.
Officials debating where the ball should be placed. The ball went out of bounds at the Upper St. Clair 38-yard line. Three officials have to dig over to Coach Render, let him know what's going on.
Territory at their 45-yard line, first and 10 after the penalty was assessed.
As we had said last week, there is a distinct difference between the rules and the referee's interpretation.
Special thanks goes out to Chuck, the Hawkeye section, for his expertise spotting plays, tackles, and numbers this evening. Thank you, Chuck.
You know, Mike, looking over to this USC side, you're looking around to see orange, red, I know,
Coglin's pass is complete to number 11, Morgan Lee. Tackle number 24, Danny Emma. Game of 9, second down line for the Panthers. Sports Network. You can listen to the game anytime you like to, including right now on your iPhone by logging on to msasports.net. The exclusive home for the WPIAL playoffs and championship games is the MSA Sports Network. Sam Hall and Johnny Lee on the call. Welcome, fellas. The Chain crew this evening, led by Jesse August, Tom Polhan, James Peterson, and Scott Storenko. I'd like to thank our message center this evening, led by Mr. John Lorenzi, Manny McGuash, John Gentile, Mike Ribbon, and Lauren Hallbreder.
Panthers will go for two here.
The Panthers will go for two. Cardinals pass incomplete to number 42, Tim McKinsey.
The Panthers here score 17-10.
Cornell Reeves up to St. Clair 17, back to Park 10. Hey, Hawk fans, let's thank our sponsors for this evening. Kimberly Clark Consumer Products, the most trusted and recognized consumer brand. For all your chiropractic needs, call Bethel Park Chiropractic Clinic. Dr. Brasil and his staff have been providing chiropractic care to Bethel Park athletes and their families for over 25 years. Call Bethel Park Chiropractic Clinic for a free exam to see if Dr. Marcinic can help you. 412-835-0636. Fire.
Second lead so far this game.
Minton. And Schmidt back to receive for Bethel Park. Stolnacker kicking off for Upper St. Clair.
Attention to the knife right now.
Ball spotted at the 29-yard line of the Panthers, first down 10. On the carry, tackle by number 21, Gary Gerst. We have a third down two for the Panthers inside a minute left to play in the third quarter.
Mike Ryan. I'm the father of a former Bethel Park athlete. We were fortunate enough to have BPTV cover our home games. We took one of the CDs and forwarded it off to different coaches of schools my son was interested in. We had an immediate response, and my son was now very fortunate to be able to play college ball. And I credit BPTV for that. So I would recommend that you get a hold of your heads of boosters and talk to them about doing home games. It makes for a great recruiting tool. It's also a great gift for grandma and grandpa, and it's also a great keepsake for years to come. Contact BPTV and help them help you.
Hey, ready?
Of course I am.
What are you waiting for?
I was waiting for you.
So we're gonna continue the puppy thing real quick.
Okay, places everyone.
In a minute!
Do I have to do everything myself?
You can't do it all by yourself.
I'd say that.
Sure I can.
No, he can't. And neither can I. So why don't you come on down to BPTV and help us make some of the great community programs you see on this station every day.
Yeah!
I mean, we can help you make your TV show ideas a reality.
It's pretty awesome.
So come on down. I mean, I am pretty good. But I'm sure I can use your help.
Has been under Panther first down.
This for the most part,
flag on the play.
First down or not will depend on
holding Upper St. Clair. Ball's now spotted at the 29-yard line of Upper St. Clair.
Looks like about 22.
Bring up a first down on 23 for the Panthers. Second down, 17 for the Panthers. Third down and four for the Panthers at their 48-yard line. by number 34, Connor McGinnis.
Time
out for a mission.
Not from here, we cannot tell. Yeah, we're about dead on the ball. Great on it.
That was all spot in Bethel Park territory at their 48-yard line. First and 10 for the Panthers.
I said no, no big by anything that
would just be. with the mistakes. And what is the mistake? What is your scene?
Ball is spotted in Panther territory at their 44-yard line. Here come the Hawks. First down, 10. Okay. Portland on the keeper.
5 yards.
Back to number 91, Michael Brooker. Gain of 6, second down and 4 for the Panthers. First down 10 after a 33-yard line with 5 minutes left to go in the contest. Tackle by number 21, Kyle Page. Gain of 3. Second down, 7 for the Hawks.
Gain
on the carry.
Down about a third and eight.
Loss of 2. Tackle by number 75, David Dougherty.
Now 4 minutes and it is winding down. The clock has just started.
Bring the third down 8 for the Hawks.
That'll bring up about 4 to 7.
Tackle number 72, John Milford.
Oh, that's definitely...
Thank you.
2, their best record since 2009. That'll play USC's undefeated streak.
As the board says, welcome to senior night. Welcome to our senior night.
Victory formation, and that should do it. That should do it through the game. That will be the game, folks. No more time left on the board. The bench is watching. One seed by a score of 24-17. And if I had to say anything to all those people that said, you're not going to win, you're going to get blown out. Look at it now. The players are trying to shake hands with the USC, but the fans on the field are not letting them. As the fans and Spurs off the field. Oh my. Mike, I am speechless right now. This is such a huge win for the Hawks program. 5-2. With that, depending on how Mount Lebanon does tonight, they could move up to take sole possession of second place in the Great Southern Conference. Not only is this a great win for the fans, for the town, for the students of the school, but for the football team. Coach McMahon, he has been under a lot of fire in the past 2 or 3 years, you know, with a 4-5, 4-6 record.
Far beyond. Oh my.
All right, folks. I mean, I honestly hate to leave. So many thanks tonight. Thanks to Mrs. Schuneman, that lifeguard, for letting us use the room. Thank you to Mr. Cable, BBTV, for giving us the opportunity.
Thank you, Matt.
Thank you, Matt, for coming out 2 weeks in a row to help us with the camera. I'd like to thank Mike for coming out every week since week two for helping me broadcast. Thank you to the Belfort fans, Belfort student section, and the players for another hard-fought win, another thriller. This, folks, is just too good to be true. A great win for this coach. A great win for Levi McLean, the freshman quarterback. One of the biggest games that he might ever play in high school. Coming out, getting this kind of victory. You're going to be hearing his name. And you're hearing about him now. You're going to hear about him. You have 3 more years of him. That's all I have.